I think we're on something very big, we're on something special. I think the market's only just waking up to that. The next drilling campaign is very exciting because we'll be starting drilling out. So we think the dolerites, if that's the case, are huge, and that's the entrapment zones where gold typically goes in all the big WA deposits.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me in the studio today is Justin Virgin. He's Executive Director at Terrain Minerals. Justin, very good to have you in the studio for a change.
You know, it's nice to meet people in person.
Great. So Justin, for viewers new to Terrain Minerals, tell us a bit more about your projects and your strategy.
Terrain, we've basic exploration company. We like to have a pipeline of projects that we're slowly bringing on because you do kill them off when you're an explorer. But the exciting thing for Terrain is our Smokebush project looks like it's got two real deals happening. We've just done some fantastic results for gold and silver at our Lightning prospect. And it looks like we've found the components or potentially dolerites that are sucking all the gold in. So we've been drilling this the wrong way potentially. And now it means it's going to be a lot bigger than we really thought. So it's just really exciting. And obviously we've got gallium in a different geological setting at Smokebush as well, at Larin's Lane. And the government's currently doing metallurgy work for us and they're paying for it. And that's due in December. So it's exciting to have two real things happening. And you know, gold and silver, who doesn't want to be in gold and silver, especially high grade in this market?
I mean, what's the significance of that correlation between gold and silver for the project's potential value, Justin?
I think it talks about the style of mineralization that we've got there, but it's an extra credit. Silver's potentially going to be on the US critical minerals list, which helps. So it's a nice credit to have, and the price is rising. We need a lot more drilling, I think, before we start talking exactly what we have. But it's just exciting to have more value.
I mean, you've mentioned also follow-up plan drilling at Lightning and also the Monza prospect. What are the key objectives of the next phase of work at those prospects?
We're calling it Lightning now because Monza, the geological model's changed as the last few weeks, so it's just Lightning. The way we were picturing it before has drastically changed. There's drilling coming up there, and that's the obvious one. We're trying to get a JORC resource by mid-next year. But it's Wildflower, which is the southern part of the tenement. We've just done IP survey because IP is unlocked Lightning, and that IP data and research will be out shortly. So watch out for that on the ASX. And you know, there's a good chance there might be a couple of really nice other targets emerging. And we've already got some nice drilling there, but the IP will tell us exactly where to drill.
You also mentioned gallium also there at Smokebush. Tell us more about the prospects for gallium.
So gallium is sitting in the sand or in a regolith. It's in a big drainage channel into a distinct, basically two granites have come up. So it's a very distinct geological setting. There's big zones of gallium up to 64 metres thick from surface in many places. 54 grams a tonne of the highest grade we got. It needs a bigger drill out. We have a JORC exploration target on 25% to the 27 square kilometres. So this is scale, it's huge. So all rare earths, all special metals, it comes down to metallurgy. So WA government through the MIWA funding opportunity is basically paying for that at Curtin University. And in December we'll have that, those results back, and that'll basically allow us to take the project further. But China's got 98% of the gallium market. There is a need for gallium globally. There's no AI or quantum computing without gallium components. You know, even LED lights and lasers, you can't have them without gallium. And one party's got all of it.
So how do critical minerals like copper, gallium and rare earths fit into your longer term growth strategy, Justin?
I think they're critical, and I think the global growth. So for us, it's gold and silver, that's real. So we're pushing forward there because that's where the short term money is. Obviously, we can then move into these other projects, but we've got a lithium project, Kalindi, up in the Pilbara. We're doing some soils on that because half of it's now granted. We have some copper and gold targets over in Queensland. We haven't quite got there yet, and we're hopefully to do some early work next year. But I think it's important to have a spread of commodities. We've always taken a view that it's more about the project than the commodity, within reason, and that's how we've ended up with a bit of a mismatch. The gallium was a mistake. We're looking for something else. And our Lort River project down in Esperance in West Australia, we were chasing a nickel target, and we found super high grade rare earths. So we're going to do a little bit more work there as well. And that's also in a very unique geological setting. So we're pretty good at finding things we're not looking for, but you know, you take what you get.
What does your cash runway look like, though, as you try to get these projects forward?
We're always broke. We're a junior. It's just the nature of exploration. We raise, campaign raise, we then go and commit those funds and do the work and hope that we get some good results. Like, once going back to Smokebush, our gold-silver project at Lightning, this is 5 years of, there's over 60 holes into this. This has taken a long time, new models, new theories, new sets of eyes, perseverance. So, and if you persevere, you eventually get there.
And are you encouraged by what you're seeing at the moment, Justin?
100%. I think we're on something very big, we're on something special. I think the market's only just waking up to that. The next drilling campaign is very exciting because we'll be starting drilling out. So we think the dolerites, if that's the case, are huge, and that's the entrapment zones where gold typically goes in all the big WA deposits. So it's this is the real deal, and people are just now waking up to it.
So take us through some of the milestones that investors should be looking out for in the near term.
Short term, some IP data will be coming out with some new drill targets, we hope. There'll be drilling at Lightning and more drilling there, a reasonably large program. We'll also test potentially some of these new drill targets if they come in down at Wildflower. There's the metallurgy studies that are happening at Larin's Lane on the gallium. There are also some rare earth component to the gallium as well. What else we've got coming up? We've just done some soils in our Kalindi project. We've got 15 kilometres of a structure a long strike from Wildcat Resources, never been looked at, 3 metres undercover. So that's exciting. And we're doing a machine learning study at the Kalindi Pilbara project as well, which is, I believe, is how the Hemi 10 million ounce deposit was found just down the road. So let's see what that turns up. So there's a lot of news in the system. We're at Lort River. We're planning to do a little bit of drilling down there in the new year. So there's more than enough to keep investors happy and keep the market moving.
I hope you'll keep us abreast of your achievements as you reach them. Thank you very much for coming to the studio today.
Thank you very much for having me.
That's Justin Virgin, Executive Director at Terrain Minerals.